You know why I'm contacting you?
Not a single clue.
Not a clue?
On the night of December 3rd, Fort Collins police stopped Harris Elias because the officer said he didn't yield the right of way to pedestrians in a crosswalk.
How much alcohol have you had tonight? Is there a reason why you don't answer questions?
Legally, Harris knows he doesn't have to answer most questions, and he has a reason for not trusting police.
I can smell a faint odor of alcohol coming from your breath or your person.
And then the fact that you say you smell alcohol is a lie. It's an outright lie.
Harris Elias says the arrest had him seething.
I was angry. I had heard this song and dance before.
Heard this song and dance before nearly 2 years earlier in Loveland.
So the reason I asked you out of the car is obviously I could smell an overwhelming odor of alcohol.
That was a Loveland police officer who arrested Elias despite the breathalyzer results.
I understand that you blew triple zeros. So that leads me to believe that there's something else going on.
Blood results for alcohol or drugs would later show not detected. So, fast forward to December 2021, when Elias would again be placed in the back of a police car for DUI.
Jesus Christ!
Elias says the officer slammed the door on his knee, which becomes significant later at the jail.
We are at the jail now. We're going to start a breath test.
Officer Jason Haferman turns off his body cam audio just as he's about to give Elias the breathalyzer test. When he turns the audio back on...
Are you needing immediate medical attention to where we need to go to the hospital now?
He offers to take Elias to the hospital to have his knee examined. And because breathalyzers have to be conducted within 2 hours of a traffic stop, this means he can demand a blood draw from Elias instead of just the breathalyzer.
They use that as, in my opinion, a pretext to avoid getting the immediate results on the breath test and to go for the bigger fishing expedition with the blood results at the hospital.
Attorney Sarah Schelke says blood results for alcohol and drug came back not detected once again, exonerating her clients.
Police retaliate against people who don't immediately do whatever they tell them to do.
Do you think officers maybe have an unconscious bias to think when a guy won't answer questions, he must be hiding something?
Well, that's part of our training. We make sure that that's not the case.
We asked Fort Collins Police Chief Jeff Swoboda if it was appropriate for his officer to mute his body cam just as he was about to give Harris Elias a breathalyzer.
Yeah, he muted it when he got on the phone, and that's one of the things we're looking into as to what was the muting for. The policy does allow us to mute the body camera from time to time.
Harris Elias says the arrest was worse than the Loveland incident because he spent 3 days in jail before he was allowed to bond out and had to deal with Child Protective Services. Because his teenage son was in the car when he was arrested, he was charged with child abuse.
As a single dad, to have that sort of intervention and a criminal charge is absolutely terrifying. They were threatening my family.
It was his girlfriend who had to pick up his son at the arrest scene.
Either he's getting blood or breath for DUI, so it's one of the two. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's...
He hasn't been drinking. He's been, like, doing...
I'm sorry
is exactly what Harris Elias would like to hear from Fort Collins Police.
And at the end, if there is something that we ever have done inappropriately, I'm not above apologizing to people.
Chief Swoboda says anytime DUI results come back negative, his department does an internal review.
It's concerning that later it came back that he didn't consume any, but that doesn't mean that the officer didn't smell alcohol inside the car on his breath or on his person.
But Chief, isn't that exactly what it means?
No, you could have alcohol on your body, you know, somebody spills on you, you're smelling something.
I want accountability from the top down. I want them to know that these issues matter.
So you want to know what's really shocking is what we learned after interviewing Harris Elias and the police chief. Turns out this one officer is responsible for 8 other DUI cases where the blood results came back negative, and another case where Judge says Officer Haferman lacks credibility. So much more to this story coming up for you tonight at 10.
All right, we're looking forward to that. Real quick, before you go, you were able to track down other people arrested by this officer, maybe in the same situation?
Correct, yeah. We actually interviewed 4 of the men, all of whom say Haferman should be fired. He's now the focus of an internal affairs investigation, but he has not been suspended. We're going to show you the body cam. You can decide for yourself if this officer had probable cause or not.